हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन अबाउट द पोयम ब्रुगल्स विंटर. ओके, एंड दिस इज द ए पोयम दैट्स टू मेक आर कंपोज्ड बाय टू सी ए पिक्चर्स. ओके, एंड द पोयम इट इज द पेज ऑन पेज नंबर 28 एंड दिस इज द पेंटिंग. You can see here the this in the picture. This is the painting, and in this painting you can see some of the hunters in the snow. And this is by the famous 16th century Dutch Flemish painter Pieter Bruegel. Okay, it is the Dutch Flemish painter Pieter Bruegel. Okay, and in this picture you can see different kind of the scene. Like some of the hunters that standing here and bending down to go by feet, and here the some of the field there are many person that looks like a black spot, and here is the some of the mountain that's standing with his peak, and you can also see here the some of the birds like a crow who flying in the sky, and you can also see the wall of the green wilds that you can see in the pictures. And this is the condition that the poet, it means composer of the poem, to say to us that how can we composed a poem or described in the words the images by the painter. Okay, so now we read a poem that extract from the poem Bruegel Winters by Walter de la Mare. Okay, and in this poem the poet, it means Walter de la Mare, compare the poem with the painting to understand how the poet describe in the words the image by the painter. Okay, so looks here the poem will we can start the poem. So let's see here. Jug mountain peak and skies ice green. Okay, jug mountain, it means the rubbed mountain, and it has a peak. Okay, large peak, and the skies are looks like a ice green. And why? Because there was a wild wall. Okay, that there are many trees that looks like a wall, and you can also see the scene of the cold area. Okay, and that scene was cold cold area in front of the wall in the wild. Okay, and you can also see the some of the churches, field, and bear crops means dense forest, it means small forest, and see that was the freezing quiet. Okay, it was the covered by the winter or snow winter, and wear ink black shapes on field in flood. In the pictures you can also see that here is the some person to playing and skirting and sleeping here, and they are looks like a black spot, ink black spot in the field, and they are curling, skating, and sliding there, and enjoying their life very well. And next, to left a goblet turban. Okay, goblet turban means and in with the goblets. Okay, it means the a corner of the room. Corner of the room, it means goblet turban, and this is the a small hotel. And we can also say it in, okay, where the some person are standing and burning or lighting the blaze means flame, and they were present watching child and some other person that standing there. And you can also see it in the given picture look like here. You can see here some of the person standing around the flame, and they also take the place inside of the fire or blaze, And next you can see here that muffled, mute beneath naked trees. It means there are many trees that looks like a naked. It means he has no any leaves and any fruits or flowers. And in shapes perspective set arrow. And their shape looks like a bigger than he has looks. Okay. And turds huntsman. It means the person who went by feet. It means there are many huntsmen that go by feet, and they was very sinister. It means they were very sad to take his. He also hold his spears, and they also bow his head down. And dogs snuffing behind them in the snow and the snow field. There are after behind the hunters. There are many dogs that snuffing. It means taking long breath behind the hunters. Okay. And next line, it means last line is, you can see that here is the poet says that, what he said that there was a crow, you can see in the picture, there was a crow who flying in the air looks like a thin arrow. Okay, like a thin arrow. And he also swoops into the space field like a crow. Okay, the crow was spooking into the space very fastly. Okay, so this poem has been completed, and in this poem the poet explained to see the pictures, and these pictures composed into the bird and the words, and that will be poem. Okay, I hope everyone understand this poem very well, and thank you for watching this video.